guys, it's day two at this private location. It's a bit quiet today and there are cows in the field, as you can see over there. I just got the signal. It's coming up on the scale, high ring coin scale, so probably about 1240 on your e-tracks, for those e-track users. I just got a signal, I found it, and it's this. It looks like some kind of a brooch, and it's yellow gold, rose gold coloured, and looks really pretty. So I'm wondering if I have a bit of gold here, because it's not discoloured anywhere, but I'll wash it up and we'll see what it is. But it's a beautiful little brooch with intact with slide, so we'll see if there's any hallmarks on it, see if it's a piece of gold. But it's looking promising. I'll get back to you. Sadly, it just looks to be plated and it's falling apart, but it's a pretty little thing. I can tell it's plated looking at the inside of there. It's a plated little brooch, but that's a shame, but it's a nice little artifact and we'll get going. And about 2 minutes later, we got our first old coin of the day. It's a sixpence dated 1954, so it's Queen Elizabeth. So it's 8 years off being silver, but it's another old coin. It's a nice find. Looks to be in good condition. We'll get going. Hey guys, I'm back. It's been a while and I've been travelling up this hill, you can see. I think I just got something. And I think it might be some piece of surveying kit. It's a what looks like a plumb bum. See the loop, hanging loop at the top, and this would drop down. It would give you a perfect perpendicular line to the ground. I'm sure you know that, but it looks like a hanging. It looks like a plumb bum, but I'm not sure what it's made up of. It came up on the high end of the scale, like a coin. But it's quite odd. It doesn't look completely regular, so it might be quite old. But it wasn't that deep, as you can see. It was in the first 2 inches of sod there. So it's quite an interesting find, and we'll keep going. Okay guys, it looks like we've just got ourselves an old copper. Farthing sized, quite thick, so and the colour of it looks like a copper. I can see Britannia on the back. You probably can't see that because the macro and zoom is pretty poor on this. But looks like it's going to be a George IV laurel head. Lorette head. So 1821-5, I believe, which is pretty awesome because that's my second George IV coin ever. But I'll wash it up and we'll see for certain. Trust me to be wrong, it's actually a young head Queen Victoria. So it's one the one she issued from the beginning of her reign to 1860 when it changed to bronze coin. This is pure copper, but it's definitely a young head. Can't see a date on it yet, but that's the first one I found like that in that style, so that is awesome. I'm very happy with it, and we'll keep going. I'll show you some macro shots. Okay guys, I may as well do this a bit of this live. I got a good signal, 4 inches. It's coming up high scale on the coins. Let's see if we can find it. Looks like we've got ourselves a coin. Yep, we do. Fantastic. Glad I get that on camera. It's George V. Immediately George V. Penny. 1917. Easy as that. Great. On to the next. Okay guys, as I have the camera out, let's do a recap of what I've found so far. We got the three old coins, the penny, the farthing and the sixpence, and current clad totals, £2 coins, two 10p's, 20p, steel two pence piece and 2 1 pennies, so that's equivalent of about £2.44. That is it's about $3.86 so far, which is a good toll. So I'll keep going along here and let's see what else we can find. Well, I don't know if it's this field or it's just the fact that loads of surveyors have been coming through here or what, but I don't know. But they all seem to be losing their plumb bums, the hanging weights on the end, because this looks like I found another one. Same thing hanging weight at the top, this looks more modern. It's very odd. I mean, there hasn't been any building on here, or building or any structure for hundreds and hundreds of years, so at least that, because there's no sign of it, and the owners of the house have been private for that long, so I don't know what they've been doing, but they obviously keep losing their hanging weights. Another hole, another live exhumation. I don't know why I said it like that, but anyway. Got this signal. I've been scanning around the hole. I couldn't find the signal originally with the pinpointer. It's on its last legs, I think, with that. But we can keep going with it. But anyway, I was scanning around the hole. I couldn't find it in the hole. I was about to dig here, and I'm really glad I didn't, because I was just looking around the hole visually, just to check, look at all the rocks and everything. I spotted this. Now, I believe that is a coin, because I can see underneath. It's very flat, and it's quite loose in the hole. It looks quite small, so I don't know if it's modern or old, but we'll find out together. It's out, and it looks old. It looks like it might be. If it's old, it's a farthing. If it's modern, it's a penny. So, I'm not seeing anything on it at the moment, but it looks like it's copper. So, let's just hope that it's a farthing. I'll get back to you. Oh, baby. I knew this field would give it up for me. This is, in fact, a William IV. So, it's the oldest coin I've found in this field so far. It's 1831 to 1837. And that's also the first William IV coin I've ever found, so I'm really happy with that. That is great. It's pure copper. So it beats the other Queen Victoria I found, but this is getting out to be a great day. I've found four old coins now, the rest clad, so about 12, I think it's 12 coins now, but that is fantastic. I'll show you some macro close-ups of that. Okay, guys, I've got another coin. It's been a while, and it's taking its toll on me a bit, but it's a halfpenny. And I know SSJ will comment on me calling it what sounds like a hate me, but it's a half penny. It's dated 1897. Yeah, that's right, 1890. I believe that's 1897, but the 7 looks really odd. That might be quite a rare variant, but it looks like it's been holed. Someone's holed it in the centre to use it as a washer, which is a real shame. And I did, you can't see in there, I grazed it slightly, but it's been holed by a square nail. So if it was a rare variant, it's not going to be worth much at all anymore, because I've damaged a poor coin. It's been through the wars, as it looks, but coin anyway, and I'm happy. So let's move on. So guys, I've got a beautiful signal here. 6-inch signal. Sorry about that, I was just trusting the strap there. 6-inch signal. Perfect coin reading. Persistent. And the last time I had a 6-inch target like this, it was the half crown. That is the Victoria half crown. Now, I'm not tempting fate here, but it's a good sounding signal, so I'm hoping I can get a coin live on camera for you. Sorry if it's a bit jittery, I'm just trying to dig the plug amongst all these tough grass roots. There we are. It looks a bit damper here, so. Okay, guys, got a signal here. Perfect coin sounding signal. So I'm doing a bit of a makeshift live dig here, because the tripod's elsewhere and all that. So it's hoping it will cooperate with me and balance on the detector there. Now there we are. Not out the hole yet. which I don't like at all, really, because hoping it's something when you're on the microphone there, but this digging line, this is the worst part of it for me, because you don't know if it's something valuable. Even if it's a penny, it's still valuable in some sense of the word, because you risk. This is the part that I fear. Oh, I seen it. It's a button. But that gave me a shock there, because as you can see, there is a silver colouring to it. Oh, sorry about that. There's a silver colouring to it, and I thought there, that was genuine surprise. I thought that might have been silver, but I think it might be silver plate. I'll just stick macro on. Well, the final hurrah before the lights out. Sun setting now, so it's about 8:30 at night. I just found this fantastic coin. It's a William III halfpenny. It's my first William III coin ever, so I'm really chuffed with this. Copper halfpenny, dated between 1695 and 1701. So it's a fantastically old coin as well, and it's the oldest coin from this field. So I'm super, super happy with this. With this part of the field anyway, and because I think I realised I said earlier that the William IV might have been the oldest, that was wrong, it was the George III, but now this is the oldest coin of the field, and for that we can be sure it's William III halfpenny. Awesome coin. I'll take some macro images and we'll keep going.